This is the future. Evolution. This is the future.
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. And at this moment I'm just busy draining the engine oil out of the BM. So I just found out that I can get a dropout motor for this engine if I cannot fix it, because unfortunately there's some stuff that broke while I was busy stripping it. The injector is stuck where it is, so I have to take the whole engine block to the engineers and see if we can get the injector out. And it seems like there's already steel inserts in the engine block. That means there was already damage before, and I have to see if we can engineer that thing correct. But I was at BMW today and they gave me some extra tips on how to strip the rest of the engine. So let me guys show you what's next. So at this point in time, they said I don't have to take out the entire manifold. I just need to loosen the three bolts holding the turbo. So I guess it will be those three there. If I loosen those three, then this whole manifold will come out with the block. I need to take off the EGR, which is this system here. So I'm just going to take off the EGR. The cams, as you guys can see, is there's no marks there. I'm going to have to actually turn the engine now, get it to the TDC, and then I have to make my own marks on the cams. Then I have to strip the two cams off. Well, I have to take the chain off, strip the two cams off, and then I can loosen the head bolts. And I think I've got this bolt here that I have to take off. And the guy told me there's an Allen key bolt here somewhere in front, that if I loosen that, I can loosen the tension. Once that's done, the block is off, and we can take the head in, get it schemed, and get the bloody thing back and get this engine up and running ASAP. So at the moment I'm just busy draining the engine oil. So there's the oil draining, and I might not get everything off, because like I said, the engine is not standing level, it's standing a bit skew, but I will see what I can do. Let me just make sure I can catch all this oil. The wind is blowing a bit, so it's messing the oil all over the place. But it looks like a good amount, so I might get most of it out, which is good. So here we are under the car, and we are going to, by removing this belly plate or this protector, by loosening those two screws over there, it's a star, a Phillips, and then this belly plate, you see there's the engine drain for the sump, for the engine sump. So you have to loosen that bolt and that bolt over there, and then it seems like, oh, and there's a bolt over there that you have to loosen, and then this whole thing will come off. And the reason for that is there's tools and stuff that fell on top of this belly plate that I need to get out. So I'm going to drop the belly plate anyway. Maybe we can clean the engine a bit better down here. Let me do that first. Okay guys, so the belly plate is off. So as you guys can see, there's now a nice clearance. So if I drop any more tools or anything, I will be able to pick it up on the ground. So that was actually the main reason for taking the belly plate off. Okay guys, let me quickly show you what I've done now. I've turned the engine to TDC. So you can see that cylinder one piston is on top, whereas this piston is down. Okay, good. Now since there's no noticeable timing marks and I have to strip the cams off totally, there's no point in taking that nice tool and putting that tool whatever. I have to take this whole thing off. So I'm going to the cams are rocking, so I'm going to make a punch mark there to correspond with that one there, and I'm going to make a punch mark there. Then I know exactly the cams is in the correct place. And I will also mark the gears. Okay guys, let me show you what I've done now. On the gears, I have painted it with Tippex. I've also made a small punch mark there, as well as a punch mark there. And I've also done it this side, that side, and there. So if I put the cams back exactly like they are now, then there could possibly be no way that the timing can be out. As long as I don't move the engine at all, then this is where the timing will be. Okay guys, I'm just gonna release this bracket because it's in the way of that bolt, and then I'm going to loosen these few bolts that hold the tappet cover on, and then the cam is basically loose. Only thing is this last two bolts here is a pain in the ass because I have to go get a special tool for that one now, and then we need to find out how to release the tension on the chain. But the water pump, the thermostat, everything is now loose, spinning freely, lekker. So I'm thinking I must maybe replace this bearing as well. The last thing we want is for this thing to seize up again and break my belt, and then we have a bloody overheating issue again. So that's where I'm going to stop today, until I can buy that new T30 socket with an extended bit, so that I can loosen those two bolts over there, and if I can get the cams that we can get the head off. So that might happen tomorrow. Hey guys, if you like this video, please consider subscribing to this channel. Give me a thumbs up because it will really help out this channel. and feel free to drop a comment. Then something new for you all, there's now a Facebook page, so feel free to follow me on my Facebook group. We will be discussing behind the scene features and videos that I have done. Also, don't forget to go to my website at www.cripzone.co.za, where you can go straight to my podcasts if you want to. By clicking on the podcast icon, you'll be taken straight to the Anchor podcast page where I do my podcast. And remember, when you go to my YouTube page, there will be a place where you can subscribe to my channel. And remember, if you have any comments, please feel free to drop me an email. And on my YouTube front page, there is now a PayPal donation button where you can feel free to donate to this channel to help it grow and to help to support me. Thanks for watching, and until next time, cheers.